about myself, I have a bachelor's degree in business administration with an emphasis in finance, a law degree, and an LLM in international taxation. I'm the president of Esquire Group, the company I founded almost 15 years ago. We have offices in Austria, Germany, the US, and then the United Arab Emirates, but we work with clients all over the world. We specialize in strategic consulting and international taxation, including US citizens with foreign income or assets, expatriation, family offices, succession planning, cross-border estate planning. Fluent in English and German. If you want to know a little bit more about me, look up this link. Or if you see me wandering around, just ask me. So I'm going to start off with a brief primer on gift taxes. So the U.S. levies gift tax on the giver rather than receiver, which is different than a lot of countries. A lot of countries, especially in Europe, levy the tax on the person receiving the gift rather than the person giving the gift. The value of the gift is determined on the fair market value of whatever the asset is that is being given. So for example, if you had a house that you paid $200,000 for and you were to gift it to somebody and today it's worth $300,000, the value of the gift is determined at the $300,000 market value, not the $200,000, which is also different than in some countries. As US citizens, the gift tax applies to your worldwide assets. So it doesn't matter where the assets are that would be gifted, it's always going to apply regardless of where you live. There is an annual gift tax exclusion of $15,000. And basically what that means is if I was nice enough, I could give each of you $15,000 and I wouldn't have to pay any taxes to giver, you wouldn't have to pay any taxes to the receiver, there would be nothing to file, and you can do this every year. Gifts above this amount reduce your lifetime gift tax exclusion. So every person has a lifetime gift tax, or every US person has a lifetime gift tax exclusion of $11.2 million. So that means if you give away up to $11.2 million, that can be done tax-free. And what's important to note here is these $15,000 gifts do not reduce this $11.2 million. So if you were to give a gift to one person, let's say in 2018, of $20,000, $15,000 of it would be the annual exclusion. You wouldn't have to do anything with that. And this, the additional $5,000 would reduce this $11.2 million. Okay. Now, what you have to do is you have to file a gift tax return if you exceed this $15,000. There wouldn't be any tax due, but it's basically to inform the IRS that you've used some of this $11.2 million so that they can track it and see how much you've used throughout your lifetime. If you gift over the $11.2 million throughout your lifetime, then there's going to be a gift tax, and the gift tax is 40%. So like if you gifted $12.2 million, you'd have gone over by $1 million, your gift tax would be $400,000. This number is adjusted for inflation, so it goes up a little bit every year. So even if you used up all of it this year, you might have, you know, another $100,000 or something that you could give away next year. A couple of special considerations, and this is what you were asking about with a non-citizen spouse. So there's an unlimited amount of gifts between U.S. citizen spouses. So if you have two U.S. citizen spouses, you can give an unlimited amount of money back and forth without reducing that $11.2 million. It has no impact on it. So between spouses, as long as they're U.S. citizens, it's no problem. Gifts to a non-U.S. citizen spouse, however, even if they're a green card holder, are tax-free only up to $152,000 a year. So for example, I was talking about the $15,000 that you could give each year. That's increased if the person's a spouse to $152,000 if they're a non-citizen. If they're a citizen, again, it would be unlimited. And if you give above the $152,000 annually, then you have to, again, file a gift tax return and it would reduce this lifetime gift tax exclusion of $11.2 million. There are some treaties between countries that deal with gift and estate taxes that could reduce that, but usually they're fairly ineffective. And then there, you can receive an so a U.S. person can receive an unlimited amount of gifts from a non-resident alien. So tax-free, so you could receive a gift of $100 million from a foreigner and there would be no tax to pay on it in the United States. If, however, it's over $100,000, you have to file a Form 3520 to report it. And the reason being is because now that it does belong to a U.S. person, when they die, the U.S. is going to levy estate tax on it. So they want to make sure if it's anything substantial coming into the U.S. tax net that they're going to track it. So it is true that U.S. people can receive gifts of an unlimited amount from non-U.S. persons, but if it's over 100,000 or more, it needs to be reported on Form 3520. So that's the overview on gift tax. Now we're going to talk about estate tax a little bit. So much like the gift tax, the U.S. levies estate tax on the decedent's estate. So basically, if a U.S. person dies, their assets go into an estate, and all the debts are paid, and the estate tax is levied on the fair market value of the assets in the estate, and then the heirs receive those assets free of tax, and for U.S. tax purposes, free of U.S. tax. The estate tax applies to the worldwide assets of a U.S. person, so it doesn't matter where these assets are located. If you're a U.S. citizen, your Dutch assets or German assets would still be included in your U.S. estate. The tax is levied again on the fair market value, not on what you paid for the assets. It's what they're worth today. You have this $11.2 million estate tax exemption, but really it's not in addition to the gift tax exemption. It's the same $11.2 million. So it's whatever you didn't use of the $11.2 million during your lifetime gifting things away is left as an estate tax exclusion. So if you use none of your gift tax exclusion during your lifetime, you would have the entire $11.2 million left to use as an estate tax exclusion. If the value of the estate goes above $11.2 million or above whatever's left of your lifetime gift tax exclusion, then there's estate tax of 40%. There's no estate tax return required if the estate does not go over this exemption amount. If it is, then you have to file an estate tax return to report the overage and pay this 40% tax. One of the things that was passed a few years back is this concept of what's called portability, which means that if one spouse dies and doesn't use any or all of their estate tax exclusion, they can give it to the surviving spouse. So let's say, for example, a husband and wife have a $20 million estate, as an example, and they're both U.S. citizens. The husband dies, and everything goes to the wife, all the assets. There would be no estate tax because it's between U.S. citizen spouses. But when she dies, without this portability, they would only have $11.2 million, which means the difference of 8.8 would be taxable. But because the husband didn't use any of hers, as long as she files an estate tax return for the husband, she can basically have his $11.2 million transferred to her, meaning when she dies, she would have a $22.4 million exemption. So at $20 million, there would be no tax due. So that's an important thing to keep in mind between U.S. and spouses with large estates. So much like gifts, a U.S. citizen spouse can inherit an unlimited amount from a foreign spouse. So if somebody's married to a non-citizen and their non-citizen spouse dies and leaves them a large inheritance, they can receive that inheritance completely tax-free. But as with gifts, if it exceeds $100,000, it would need to be reported on Form 3520. U.S. citizen spouses, much like with gifts, can inherit an unlimited amount from each other. Estates left by U.S. citizen spouses to non-U.S. citizen spouses, however, don't have any type of tax advantage. Basically, they immediately start reducing the 11.2 million. So if you remember with gifts, we had this annual amount of 152,000 that a US citizen spouse could give to a non-citizen spouse. There's no such exclusion for estates. Meaning if a US citizen spouse dies at dollar one, it starts reducing this 11.2 million dollars. So it gets pretty tricky for US citizen spouses leaving estates to non-citizen spouses that have large estates. Also, inheritance received by US persons from covered expatriates are taxed differently. Actually, I missed this on the slide with gifts before, but it applies in both cases. So, just briefly, a covered expatriate is somebody who renounced their US citizenship that had a net worth of $2 million or more, an average income tax liability of, I think, $165,000 or more, or was not tax compliant. Then they're classified as a covered expatriate. And what that means is the gift and estate tax rules basically reverse. If somebody's a covered expatriate, then any US person that receives a gift or inheritance from them will have to pay 40% estate tax with no type of exemption. So an example of this would be, let's say you have a US citizen that is a dual citizen, American and German, for example. And their children are born dual citizens, US, Germany. And at some point, the US citizen mom decides, I'm expatriating, I don't want to deal with this stuff anymore, and she's not tax compliant at the time she expatriates. She would then be considered a covered expatriate. Any money she gives her children or any inheritance she leaves them, they're going to have to pay 40% gift or estate tax on it. And there's no way out of that. The same goes for any other U.S. person.